गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी आर बैक विद द चैप्टर सेल। एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वेरी फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर इन माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर, आई होप यू ऑल हैव वेंट टू दैट। एंड टुडे विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग ऑन द नेक्स्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर एंड वी आर फॉलोइंग ऑक्सफोर्ड बायोलॉजी क्लास सिक्स। सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू ओपन योर बुक बिकॉज आई विल बी टेलिंग सर्टन पेज नंबर्स एंड सर्टन डायग्राम्स दैट यू नीड टू मार्क एंड यू नीड टू गो थ्रू दैट पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम्स। ओके, सो मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द structure and the structural and the functional unit, that is the cell. Here I have drawn, I have tried to draw a cell which is an animal cell. Okay, now we will move into this particular diagram, but before that let us continue with what are the parts or what are the things that is available inside a cell. Okay, I am following your book. Cell. Despite the difference in their shape, size and number, the cell have been same basic internal makeup. A cell is covered or bound by a thin membrane called the cell membrane. Okay. The cell membrane encloses the living contents of the cell called the protoplasm. Okay. Many specialized structures called cell organelles can be found within the protoplasm. So, if we see this as animal cell, what we found? Inside this thing, this is the protoplasm. Okay, this whole thing is known as protoplasm. Now moving forward, see student, also try to understand that there are mainly two type of cell. Okay, one is plant cell, another one is animal cell. Here I have drawn only animal cell. The plant cell is available in your book. I'll tell you the figure number and the page number. Now there are some basic differences. There are some basic differences between these two cells. But as a whole, if you take it as a generalized cell, then we will find that everything is almost same. We will also go through the difference today only. But before that, let's move quickly to the book, the cell membrane. And before that, I want you to look into this particular diagram for once. So I hope the diagram is visible. Now you can rewind it and pause it, whatever. So moving forward, the cell membrane. What is a cell membrane? See, this outer lining, this covering is known as cell membrane. Okay, this green line, okay, it is known as cell membrane. The cell membrane is a living and elastic in nature and has tiny spores. The cell membrane is selectively permeable, that is, it allows some substance to pass through and not others. Okay, it is selectively permeable, that means that it only allows only particular substance to pass through from here to here and from here to here. Okay, now the cell wall. The cell wall is present in plant cell and not in animal cell. Thus, I have not drawn here cell wall, as this is a animal cell. Plants have an additional layer called the cell wall surrounding the cell membrane. The cell wall is non-living and is composed of cellulose. My dear student, cell wall is composed of cellulose. It provides protection and maintains the shape of the plant cell. The cell wall allows substance to enter the cell through diffusion. It is freely permeable. See, cell membrane is selectively permeable, but cell wall is freely permeable. Okay. Now, cell organelle or the cell organelle. What are the cell organelle? The things, these things, whatever is present inside a cell is known as cell organelle. Okay. Is known as cell organelle. Cell organelle are the substance, are the living membrane bound bodies that have a definite shape and function within the protoplasm. These are discussed below. Okay, so whatever it is inside the protoplasm, these are known as cell organelle. The first point is nucleus. Here you can see this red one is the nucleus. This is nucleus. The nucleus is usually spherical in shape. It controls all the activity of the cell and hence it is called the brain of the cell. Okay. It is surrounded by a double layered membrane called the nuclear membrane. This membrane contains many spores called the nuclear pores. Okay. The nuclear membrane surrounds a jelly like fluid called the nucleoplasm. So this is the nucleus and here is the nucleoplasm. For that you can go through your diagram number 2.4, okay, figure number 2.4 of page number 42 of Oxford Biology. There it is more accurately given. You can find there. The nucleoplasm contains one or more spherical body called the nuclei. Okay, singular is nucleus. The nucleoplasm also contain a network of thread like structure called chromatin. And this chromatin we will study in details in class 10. Okay, so this is known as those thin thread like substance or the structures are known as chromatin. So this is all about nucleus. Moving forward, we have the chromatin contains genes that transfer hereditary material from the parents to the offspring. During cell division, chromatin fibers thicken to form structure called chromosomes, which then divide. So these chromatin fibers, we already have heard about a term known as genes, right? We have heard about the term, but we don't know in detail. So whatever, your parents or your grandparents have the characteristics, you have at least some of the particular characteristics of your grandfather or your grandmother or any of your, that is known as hereditary characteristics. Okay, now my dear students, this comes from the chromatin fibers, and these chromatin fibers get thickened to form chromosomes which multiply during cell division. Okay, you will I will make you understand that in your higher classes. Next part is endoplasmic reticulum. So see, this is endoplasmic reticulum and this is endoplasmic reticulum. There are two endoplasmic reticulum I have drawn here. One is rough endoplasmic reticulum, another one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so what are they? It is a network of folded double membrane like channels that extend from the nuclear membrane to the cell membrane. Okay, it provides a supportive framework to the cell. It provides a support or a supportive framework to the cell. The endoplasmic reticulum allows the transport of substance within the cell as well as between the cell. Okay, now within the cell as well as between the cells, it helps the transport of the materials. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum, that I have already drawn here. One is rough endoplasmic reticulum, another one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, endoplasmic reticulum that has no ribosomes attached to it is known as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum which will lack ribosome is known as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum that has many ribosomes attached to it is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay student, I hope up till this it is clear. Now the next is, what is protoplasm? Okay, what is protoplasm? Protoplasm comprising the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Okay, now this was under nuclear membrane and nucleoplasm. Now this whole thing is under protoplasm. Okay, protoplasm comprises of the cytoplasm and the nucleus. The cytoplasm is a colorless jelly like fluid that is the site for most of the cell's chemical reaction. Scattered within the cytoplasm are the cell organelles. Okay, it is for the chemical reaction, whatever chemical reaction takes place in our body, and we will study about this organelle which is present inside the particular protoplasm or the cytoplasm. Okay, ribosomes, these are small granular structure without a membrane. They either exist freely in the cytoplasm or are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosome take part in the synthesis of protein. So what is the function of ribosome? The function of ribosome is to take part in synthesis of the protein. Okay, next is mitochondria. These are small rod like structures that are surrounded by two membranes, outer and inner. Now mitochondria have two membranes, one is outer membrane, another one is inner membrane. The outer membrane is smooth and the inner membrane is folded into finger like projection called cristae. Okay, now outer membrane is smooth, inner membrane have a finger-like projection, and this is known as Christie. Mitochondria are also called the powerhouse of the cell. They are responsible for oxidizing food to release energy during the process of cellular respiration. Okay. Now, what are Golgi bodies? Now, what are Christie? Just quickly look into it once. I am making a big diagram of this particular mitochondria. Here you will find that this type of structures. Okay, now these projections are known as Christie. These projections are known as Christie. Okay, now this is a mitochondria. Now, this is also known as the powerhouse. I repeat, this is also known as the powerhouse of the cell. Now, Golgi bodies. What are Golgi bodies? These are stacked, flattened membrane bound vesicles. Golgi bodies are involved in packaging of substances such as enzymes and hormones. They also help in formation of liposomes or lysosomes. Okay. Now, what are lysosomes? These are membrane bound sacs that contain digestive enzymes. These enzymes helps to digest old worn out cells as well as organelles and even destroy foreign bodies such as bacteria. They are often called suicide bags or the cell. So another name of lysosome is the suicide bag. Now what does it do? For example, as our excretion system does, it digests, or our stomach does, is digest the food. The same thing happens with the lysosome. Whatever need to be digested, be it the waste material or the nutrient part, it is digested in the lysosomes. Now, centrosomes, these are present only in animal cell. Okay. Now, centrosomes are not present in plant cell, they are only present in the animal cell. These are present only in animal cells and are found near the nucleus. They are not membrane bound. Centrosomes represent an area of clear cytoplasm containing two cylindrical bodies positioning at right angle to each other. These cylindrical bodies are called centrioles. Centrosomes help in formation of spindle fibers during cell division. So its work is during cell division. Here is this. Okay. Now the vacuoles. These are membrane bound hollow liquid filled structure that stores various substances in a solution. A vacuole is larger or higher in case of plant cell than in animal cell. Okay, dear students. So vacuoles, these are membrane bound hollow liquid. I have already told that in the plant cell, vacuoles are quite larger and occupy most of the cell space. So much that the nucleus is pushed towards the margin against the cell membrane. If present in animal cell, vacuoles are much smaller in size and more in number. See, I have already done here vacuole. They are smaller in size and more in number. But in plant cell, what happened? It is a big vacuole present inside the cell. Vacuoles keep the plant cell in turgid state. Okay, it gives turgidity or the support to the particular plant cell. Dissolved substances such as sugars and minerals and even waste products are available or stored inside the vacuole. Okay. Now, plastids. What are plastids? This is also available in plant cell, not in animal cell. Okay. These are found in plant cells. They are bound by a double membrane and can be oval, spherical or dicot in shape. Based on their color, they are classified into the following three types. There are three types of plastids based on their color. What are they? Chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. So what are they? They are chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. They are क्लोरोप्लास्ट क्लोमोप्लास्ट एंड ल्यूकोप्लास्ट। नाउ व्हाट आर दे, विल लर्न अबाउट देम। क्लोमोप्लास्ट दे आर ग्रीन प्लास्टिड्स एज दे कंटेन द ग्रीन पिगमेंट क्लोरोफिल। सो क्लोरोप्लास्ट कंटेन्स द क्लोरोफिल। They trap solar energy and convert it into chemical energy in the form of food through the process of photosynthesis. Chloroplasts are present in the green parts, leaves and young stem of the plants. Okay. Now, the chromoplasts, these are colored plastids. They contain red, orange and yellow pigments. Now, many of us have seen that we buy tomato from the market. The tomato is of red color. So this pigment, this particular pigment is available inside chromoplast of the particular fruits or vegetable cell. Okay. They are mostly found in the petals of the flowers and fruits. These are colored, this color attracts insect and other animal for pollination. Now, leucoplast, these are colorless plastids. So what we found, this is green in color. This is also colored, but leucoplast is colorless. Okay. These are colorless plastids that store food in the form of starch, protein and fat. They are found in roots, seed and other storage organs of the plant. So this is all about the cell organelle. We'll quickly move on to the differences. Okay. Plant cell and animal cell. Now what we have found, please refer to table number 2.1 of page number 45. You will found there plant cell and animal cell, the difference between them. So plant cell have a fixed geometric shape, animal shape they vary in the cell. Second, plant cell, cell wall is present, and here in animal cell, cell wall is absent. Plastids are present in the cytoplasm, and in animal cell no plastids are present. So it is absent. Lysosomes are not present in plant cell, but lysosomes are present in animal cells. Okay. Large permanent vacuoles are present. They fill about 90% of the space inside the cell. Here vacuoles are if present are very small. Nucleus is of marginal position in plant cell. Nucleus is in central position in animal cell. Okay. So these are few of the points you need to understand, and after that we will go through. These are the thing. One thing is, you don't need to do this. So this completes the particular chapter of cell, or cell, the structure of cell as of class 6 following Oxford Biology class 6. Okay. I hope everything is clear to you all. Please go through this particular chapter very carefully. The questions that are going to come is based on like what are the functions of the cell organelle, where it is found, where it is not found. Okay, diagrams of this particular two diagrams, one is of this animal cell that I have already drawn here, another one is of the plant cell which is present in your book itself. So these things are going to come in the exam. Okay, the differences and everything. See, I am already telling you the importance of this particular chapter. You go through this particular chapter, for any of the problem do ask me in the comment section below here, or you can directly ask me during my class timing. I hope everything is clear. Take care, take be safe as the global pandemic is going on outside. Stay in home. Keep care of yourself as all of your parents and the family members, and study hard, because exams are going to come and will not stop for this pandemic. I am trying to teach you biology, so please try and understand all this particular thing. Thank you.